Hey y'all, welcome to workout number 9 today. For equipment, you're gonna need some dumbbells for today. It's always a great idea to have maybe have a couple of different sizes in case you need to increase or decrease your weight. And if you have a sturdy table or bench, coffee table, fireplace, whatever, that will be great too. If not, I can show you an option where you can get away without that. So, let's go ahead and get started with workout number 9. We're gonna sweat it out today. Okay, let's get started with our warm-up. All right, we're gonna start with hip openers. Let's lunge down to one side, and we're gonna slide on over to the other, back up to standing, and then the other direction. These are our hips. Make sure those hips go back. Power skips on the right leg, power skips on the left leg. We're going to do dips. That's where you're going to need your table or bench for. If not, you can do them on the floor, and I can show you that during the workout. And a reverse crunch. That's all the equipment you're going to need for circuit number 1. So let's get ready to go. All right, power skips. Here we go. We're going to step it back. We're going to drive that knee up. Make sure you step straight back. Drop that back knee as far as it will go. And then drive it up with that hop if you can. If you need to slow it down, right here. Okay. Keep that head pointing to the ceiling. Don't fall forward. Keep the chest up this time, okay? So we have 3, 2, and 1. Rest. Okay, now we're gonna do the other side. Let's switch legs. Same thing. we're down. Launch up. Again, stepping straight back, keeping the front knee behind the toe, using the entire body. Remember, slow it down if needed, okay? Exhale on that lift, on that jump. We have 8 seconds. Table. If you don't have a table, you can be on the floor here, arms close to the body, and do your dips here, okay? Or if you have a table or a bench, right here. If you want more of a challenge, straighten those legs, but keep the body close to the bench. If it gets hard, bring them in and keep popping up. All right, on the floor, a reverse crunch. Okay, back foot to the floor, tap the heels into the ground, and then lift the hips off the floor. Try to use your abs to lift the hips. Not the momentum of pulling the legs towards the body. Try to keep your knees bent. And back flat. All right. Round two. Here we go. Power skips. Close to the body. Round three, last round. Let's go. job. Other side. Three, two, one. All right, back to those dips. All right, good job. Okay, last 30 seconds. Back flat to the floor. All right, circuit two coming up. You will need your dumbbells for this one. We're gonna do skaters, curtsy lunges, we'll do reverse flies, and our core, we're gonna do wipers this time. All right, let's get ready with those skaters. All right, side to side, you're gonna reach for that toe, bring that other leg back, gaze down and forward. If you need to, take a big step, slow it down, okay, or hop. You want to work on that balance. Keep that leg off the floor. Or put it down. All right. Grab a dumbbell. We're going to do our curtsy lunges. Hold it at your chest. All right. Hips remain forward. Step back and down. Side to side. And slow. You can add more weight to this if you want, or no weight at all. Just keep those hips forward and that chest up. All right, let's get ready for those reverse flies. Round those shoulders back, knees soft, hinge at the hips, exhale on that lift. All right.
going to be up to our side. Head relaxed to the floor. Drop the legs to one side. Bring them down to the other. Exhale. Now if you need to, bring the knees in and do a knee drop until you're able to straighten those legs. Okay, more advanced. Straighten those legs up and over. All right, round two. Back to the speed skaters. All right, here we go.
Thank you.
through the deck. Get ready for circuit number three. Circuit number three, we're going to do jump squats. We're going to pulse it out. We're going to do an inverted push-up, and we're going to do a plank, low plank reach, or you can do a high plank reach, either one of those. Have your dumbbells ready. Here we go. Squats are first. Use weight, no weight, whatever you want to do there. Set the hips back, and then absorb that landing as soon as your feet hit the ground. You want to set those hips right back again. You need to take out the jump. Just do your squats up and down with your weight. Okay? Or you can do your jump squats without weight. Work your weight up to those weights. Keep that chest up. Alright, you can hang on to two weights, no weights, both weights, or whatever, one weight. We're going to hold it down both for a pulse. Here we go. Hold, pulse it out. Keep that weight close to your chest. Don't let it pull you forward. You pull it back. Keep that core nice and tight. Breathe. Halfway. Up next, we're going to do inverted push-ups. If that's too difficult or awkward, you can do overhead presses with your dumbbells. Okay, either press with the dumbbells, or you can try this inverted push-up, okay? So we're like in a downward dog position. We're going to aim the crown of the head towards the floor. We're working the shoulders. I'm looking at the back wall. Exhale on that press. Good. Up from here. We're going to be in low plank on the elbows. You can do this on the knees or on the toes. And I'm just going to reach. Okay, widen your stance in the back if needed. Make sure your shoulders are right over those elbows. Keep your head in a neutral position. All right, make your way back up. Round two, squat jumps. All right, lots of reps. Slow it down if you have to. Do that squat. Focus on the form. And rest. All right, ready to pulse it out. Down and hold. All right. inverted push-ups, or again, you can do those presses with the dumbbells instead. All right, let's go. My shoulders. Yeah. Back to plank. Other plank. Here we go. Let's make our best one. Let's go. Three, two, and one. Oh goodness, that burns. All right, inverted push-up or overhead press. Bring our shoulders down and back. Let's cross our arms across the chest here. Soften the knees, hip width apart with the feet. We're gonna hinge at the hips and set the hips back to a 90 degree angle here. And then we're gonna pull back up with the backs of the legs. Let's go back down again. Exhale, hold, exhale, up. One more time down. This time I'm gonna hold right here. You should feel a stretch in the backs of the legs. Keep that back nice and flat. From here, we're gonna release the hands and reach for the floor as far as we can and relaxing the head. Deep breaths. Each time you exhale, try to go a little here, we're gonna walk it out to a plank position. We're gonna push back into a pike. And then back to a plank. Really want to stretch that hip flexor, especially if you do a lot of sitting for your job. When you do a lot of sitting, the hip flexors get really tight, which can cause low back pain and interrupt those knees. All right, let's set it back and reach our chest towards our leg. Focus on your breathing. Workout number 9. Look forward to seeing you at workout number 10. All right, you guys have a great day.